Hi guys, Nimit here, and today I have got the budget phone, the Panasonic T9, which cost me around 3K in the online market, and this is really good at this price according to specifications. I know there you can see it's having an Android 4.4 KitKat version and a dual core 1.3 GHz CPU along with 3.5 inches VGA display and remaining all, and it's a dual SIM phone. The only drawback is it does not support the 3G, and the MRP here is given is 4190 rupees and all this stuff. Just let me unbox the phone. Just allow me to open the box. And there you go, there is the Panasonic T9 device. It's having an 3.5 VGA display, which is not good but okay at the price. Looks cool, but just keep it aside. We'll check come on to that later. And let's check what's inside the box. There is an battery for the same, it's around 2000 mAh or so on, and there is a transparent silicone back cover free with the device. Stuffs, the warranty card, the user guide, and don't know what is this stuff, just keep it aside. There is a white adapter along with the USB for device charging, and there are cool Panasonic headsets. These are really pretty cool, the white color ones. They look cool at this price. This is the best, and there is nothing inside the box, just keep it aside. Let's boot the phone up. Oops, I forgot the cover. And just get the phone out. There you can see it's really cool, having a 3.5 display. At the back there is a 2 megapixel shooter along with the LED flash, Panasonic branding, and at the bottom there is a charging port along with mic. At the top there is a power key with the 3.5mm jack. At the left there is nothing, and at the right there is a volume dongle. And this phone also has a front camera, we'll come on to that later. And just allow me to insert the battery inside. Yeah, it's a dual SIM phone, and also has a micro SD card expandable up to 32 GB, and there is SIM 1 slot and SIM 2 slot. And just insert the battery, check it gets well inside. Pat the panel with few clips and hold the power key for a while. And there you go. It would take a while as this is the first boot up.
Panasonic.
There you go, Panasonic branding. Here are few language steps that every phone comes, so just let me skip it, I will check it later. Let me select English, next, and the date and time it's set to automatic, so it's okay. If you want you can change to GPS, or you can even off it, and the time format and the date format. Next, the Wi-Fi, if you are connecting to account, hit the boot up, then you can on it and connect to Wi-Fi. Google, I'll do it, all this stuff later, and just skip it as of now. And there you go, the phone is now fully booted up. There you can see the display is quite bright, so the video quality may not be good. I'm sorry for it, but the phone is really good. Let's check with the operating system version it comes. There you go, about phone. There you can see it's 4.4.2 KitKat version. It's the latest as of now, Android 4.4.2, the KitKat version it is. And just now go back and let's check the camera quality of the same. There it is. It just gives some tutorial on how to use the camera. Just keep it. It's for zooming and zooming out. Okay, now just allow me to take some random pic and show you the quality of the same. There you can go. Here, let me take the pic of the box and the flash shoots. So it's not having any sensor, so there will not be the auto flash option. And here is the pic. And again, sorry for the quality, but I'm trying my best. There you can see the camera quality of the 2-megapixel shooter is really good. For this price, I guess this is the best they can give. And that's it, guys. This was the review on Panasonic T9. It's a really budget smartphone. Thank you, and do like the video and subscribe for more. Thank you, guys.